So you just got a brand new Sony ZV-1, or you had one for a while, and you want to protect it? Well, so do I. Out of the box, the camera does not come with a case or protective elements. So let's say you want to go on a shoot or a vacation with this compact camera and decide to put it in your backpack. Well, I really don't know for how long this screen will last until scratches appear or other external elements get damaged. So let's be kind to it and look for cases. Searching on Amazon does give us some choices. For example, this case actually looks quite good. It has room for the camera, dead cat, and tripod accessory. The other choices present are not really what I'm looking for. This silicone case looks good, but it doesn't have all the protection I want. And nothing else really looks interesting to me. But let's not waste any more time. I actually have a 3D printer, so I'm gonna design and build my own case. Let's get to it. This is the case that I designed. It will have a built-in hinge for the top cover, and the internal layer will be built out of softer TPU plastic. First, I took the dimensions for the camera and started building around it. I will not replicate every surface detail of the camera, just the major features such that it will sit comfortably snug inside the TPU plastic. I have used the camera to cut the mold inside this case, and then offset the face slightly so that the printer tolerances are taken into account. The first iteration of the hinge design was too small. Later versions had thicker elements so as to not break during assembly. I also went with a very simple locking mechanism where the cover simply snaps into place. There is also a very little orifice where you can put your finger and lift the top cover up. That's it for the design. Let's start printing it. I'm gonna be honest and mention that I've never used TPU plastic before, so this would be a good test for my extruder and my 3D printer. The type of TPU material is from Sunlu, purchased on AliExpress, to which I will leave a link in the description. Let's just say that for this to print properly, it needs to be done very slowly. I used 25 millimeters per second, and the inside mold took about 18 hours to print. The good news is that the printer bed does not need to be heated. However, I did use a layer of glue to make sure that no issues surfaced with bed adhesion. Next, we move to the printing of the outer case, which was printed out of red PLA, also from Sunlu. I printed the outer case with supports, so it's time to do some cleaning. I also had some stringing present, so I decided to use a lighter to remove it. As you can see, due to the flexibility of the TPU material, it should provide a nice cushion for the camera. The tolerance is such that the inner section should fit and in theory not fall out of the outer case. If this does not work for you, a little glue should be applied in order to keep it in place. You may also notice here that the hinges are glued on. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, they were quite slim, so I had to redesign them and make them a little thicker. This is actually what happened in the first place.
No.
With all the parts assembled, let's go ahead and test fit the camera. There we go, a 3D printed case for the ZV-1, which some may consider overkill, but I'm sure the camera will be safe from falls and abuse it could be receiving in a backpack or suitcase. That's it for this one, see you on the next project.